Good afternoon, Trojans. On today's show, we'll have a fun segment from two of our senior broadcasters.
This and more coming up on Trojan TV News.
Good afternoon, Trojans. I'm Kat Charles.
And I'm Hannah Montenegro. It's Wednesday, May 15th, 2024.
Have you ever wondered about what animals you would have on a dream team?
Well, senior Trojan TV News reporters Mason Bead and Nathan Elliott did. Here is their rendition of a draft, animal style.
Good afternoon, Trojans. Welcome to a brand new segment we like to call Top 10. I'm Mason, and I'm here with
Nathan Elliott. Today, this is Top 10 Animal Auras. We're going to be doing a draft-style picking, and let's get right into it.
I'll take the honors of the first pick. Oh, with my first pick, I got to take Lion. Might be a boring, obvious pick, but
It's a solid number one. You know, for me, I'm gonna have to go for Komodo dragon for my number one pick. Have you seen these bad boys fight?
Good first pick, but with my second pick, I'm gonna have to pair the lion up with a similar animal. I'm gonna take the tigers.
Well, you just like cats over there, buddy?
I'm a big cat guy.
Aww. I'm in between two, but I think I'm gonna have to take eagle for my number two.
That's valid. I definitely had them in my top 10. To respond to that, I'll take a gorilla with my third pick.
Solid. That was a good pick. I already know what I'm taking. Going shark.
That was my next pick, I have to admit.
Can't beat a shark. Our top threes are looking pretty solid right now.
Next, I'm gonna have to take bear. I mean, maybe the most deadly animal in the world. Not much more you can say about a bear.
I'm going wolf. Everyone knows the wolves have aura. If you're talking aura, whenever you think of aura in animals, you think of the wolf.
It's like a sigma animal. Oh, with my next pick, I'm gonna have to take cheetah. I mean, come on, fastest animal on earth. Like, that in itself is aura.
You know what? I'm going peacock. Peacocks are a beautiful bird. That's how I look about, buddy. Peacocks are a beautiful bird. They flare up their things. They're literally known for being beautiful and having aura. So they're gonna have to go number five for me.
My next one, I'm gonna take snake. I mean, King Cobra has to have a spot in the top 10, to be honest. Like, there's a number of snakes you can go with.
But what's your top snake?
My top snake, I mean, when it comes to aura, like, they're called the King Cobra for a reason. You know?
I think I'm gonna go with the fox, though. Foxes are sly, they're clever. Quite frankly, they got that Riz.
To combat the Rizzler pick, with my next one, okay, I know it says narwhal, but we're calling an audible here. I'm gonna call it a killer whale. It's an orca. That's what's gonna be on my top 10.
You forgot to do six.
It's going to number six, actually.
Dolphins are also threats down there. They're beautiful. Fish, whatever they're called.
Fish eye?
Yeah. That's Riz right there.
I'm gonna take a little freshwater animal and go with crocodiles.
Ooh.
Them things are dangerous. I have to put it right there.
I can get behind that.
Yeah, that's a good pick.
But for me personally, going for the good old rhino.
That was gonna be one of my next picks off the board.
Rhino going in hot at number eight.
They are endangered though.
Yeah, okay. because how much aura they have.
I'm gonna have to take panther. Like, sorry to all my Trojans out there that hate the Park Hill South Panthers, but like, Black Panther has aura for a reason. Like, shout out Chadwick. Like, that's my guy.
Rest in peace, Chadwick. I told you before this started, Mason, that this was gonna be a sleeper pick for me. All right. I told you it would be at a cool little nine spot. You didn't quite agree, but I'm leaving it there, all right? It's up for the Park Hill Trojans to decide. We're putting Flamingo coming in hot at number nine. Beautiful bird, literally speechless.
But I think for the 10th spot, I'm gonna have to go Jaguar. I mean, there's not much more to say. I got like the quad, tiger, lion, cheetah, panther, jaguar.
I think I'm going leopard. I have to go leopard. That's
had to get a big cat on there.
Yeah, I had to get a big cat in there. I can't make a top 10 list with no big cats.
All right, that's it for our top 10s. There'll be a QR code up on the screen. You guys can go vote for which one is better. But that's it from us too for the first ever Trojan TV News top 10 segment. Let's send it back to the desk.
Thanks, Mason and Nathan. It's been pretty warm outside recently.
Yeah, but I heard it's supposed to rain. Let's send it over to Javion to find out more.
Thanks, Hannah and Kat. Looking at today's weather, it does look to be a little droopy outside, a little gray. It is 71 degrees right now, and today is supposed to be a high 73 and a low of 61. It's supposed to be a little cloudy outside, so don't expect much sunshine these next couple of days. But heading into the rest of the week, I know on Thursday it is supposed to rain a little bit, so do keep that umbrella or that hoodie in that bag to protect you from the weather or the elements outside. But the next couple of days is supposed to look beautiful outside with those 80 temperatures, even getting up to 87 on Saturday with those low 90 degrees. And Sunday and Monday, I know it's supposed to look pretty good too with just minimal clouds. So Tuesday and Wednesday, looking into the rest of the week, it is supposed to get a little bit cloudy and a little, and there are supposed to be a couple storms. So make sure you do keep that umbrella or that hoodie inside of that bag to protect you from the elements. Back to the desk.
Thanks, Javion. I heard baseball has districts coming up.
Yeah, let's pitch it over to Colton to find out more.
Thanks, Hannah and Kat. The boys' tennis team competed in the Class 3 state quarterfinals at home yesterday. The Trojans gave it their all but fell to two-time defending state champions Pembroke 5-1. They end their season with a conference and district championship and a record of 16-2 overall. The boys' golf team state qualifiers completed the second round of the Class 5 state tournament in Jefferson City yesterday. Zach Cato shot an 83 for a combined two-day score of 153 and ended the tournament in a nine-way tie for 39th. Alejandro Magana Cardenas shot a 79 for a combined two-day score total of 157 and finished in sixth for a six-way tie for 59th. Coming up on the Trojan Varsity Sports calendar for today, the baseball team begins Class 6 District 8 play at Liberty North against High School Oak Park at 4 p.m. Trojan TV News reporter Nathan Elliott caught up with Caden Pack to get a preview of this afternoon's game.
I'm here with Caden Pack, a varsity baseball player. You guys have districts Wednesday, right?
Yep.
All right, and how has your team been preparing for district play?
Just practicing, you know. You can't really do a lot at this point in the season, so we're just excited to play.
Oh, yeah, it's coming down to the wire. What do you think you guys, like, what's your strongest part of this team been so far?
You know, honestly, we're a comeback team. We like to get down early, so just our fight and how we like to stay in the games.
Oh, yeah, you guys like to rally up, huh? And how far do you think you guys will get in district play? You think you're making it to state?
Hopefully. I mean, you never know. It's baseball, so anything can happen. We're in a good district, so we'll see what happens.
Oh, yeah, that'd be a nice way to go out, wouldn't it?
Yep.
All right, man. Thanks for coming out.
Yep.
Back to the desk.
Please listen for announcements over the PA for any schedule changes due to inclement weather. That's your Trojan Sports Report. I'm Colton Beagle. Now back to Kat and Hannah.
Thanks, Colton. The following clubs and activities have meetings after school on Thursday. The Anime Club will have its last meeting of the year in room 413, and Gaming Club meets in room 27.
All boys and girls interested in running cross country in the fall should plan to attend an informational meeting tomorrow after school in room 330. If you are unable to make it, contact Coach Gardner in room 330. That's all we have for you today. I'm Kat Charles.
And I'm Hannah Montenegro. Have a great day, Trojans.